Good morning, friends. Welcome to our channel, Be a Wise Investor. Yesterday, Nasdaq closed with a loss of 62 points at 14,283.91, and Nasdaq future is now trading with a loss of 75 points. Dow Jones closed with a gain of 71 points at 35,630.68, whereas Dow Jones future is now trading with a loss of 91 points. S&P 500 lost 12 points and closed at 4,576.73. All European markets ended in red. GIFT Nifty is trading with a loss of 51 points as of now. All Asian markets also trading in red. Indications are that Indian markets may open with a little negative or without much change, and Nifty may show some gain in the middle way and decline sharply in the second half as FII is selling in the last 3 days and seems to be continuing. More volatility may be seen in the banking sector in the coming days due to the announcement of credit policy, which may happen on 10th of this month. FIIs were net sellers to the tune of just 92.85 crores, whereas DIIs were net buyers to the tune of 1035.69 crores yesterday. FIIs bought a net of 13,922.01 crores in July, whereas DIIs sold 1,184.33 crores. FIIs bought a total of 74,740.30 crores in this financial year so far, and DIIs also bought 2,184.12 crores in this financial year so far. Berger Paints will be in limelight today as the company announced the board will consider bonus issue on 9th August 2023. Company's last bonus issue was in the year 2016, and so far they declared 6 bonus issues. So this bonus issue may be a liberal one. Promoters holding in this company is 75%, the maximum allowed. Piramal Pharma shares will be trading X rights today. The rights issues at the rate of 81 rupees per share and will be given in the ratio of 5:46. Kotak Mutual Fund Managing Director Nilesha says that IT sector will continue to be hit in their revenue. Also, he opined that defense sector may be riskier in short term. The F&O rollover position in August series suggests that there may be more rise in the stock markets. India's manufacturing PMI falls marginally to 57.7% in July. DLF promoter sold his entire stake of 0.59% shares, that is 1.45 crore shares, via open market operations at the rate of Rs. 504.21 per share. Maruti announced the production of 1.86 lakh vehicles in July as against 1.85 lakh vehicles in the same period last year. TVS Motor recorded a sales volume of 3.26 lakh vehicles in July as against last year's 3.12 lakh vehicles. Electric vehicle sales doubled to 13,306 from the last year's sale of 6,304. Power Grid received board approval for implementation of 85 megawatt solar power project at Nagda in Madhya Pradesh. ITR filing in the assessment year 2024 increased by 16% at 6.77 crores. Sterling and Wilson Renewable Energy has received a new order for Rs. 360 crore, which is apart from the already received order of Rs. 466 crores. Current market price of the share is 394. Ashok Leyland announced a sale of 15,068 units, a rise of 10.6% over last year. Eicher Motor sales grew by 32% year on year to 73,117 units. SML Isuzu registered a sale of 1,250 units, a rise of 23% over last year. Thermax reported 0.1% year-on-year decline in net profits. Internationally, battery company committed to invest $1 billion in southern Karnataka. Bosch Limited is looking to boost its manufacturing in India over the next 2 to 4 years. Pravesh Gaur of Swastika Investmart has given 3 hot stocks for the next 3 to 4 weeks. The first one is Sunflag Iron & Steel. Last trader price 240.60, stop loss 220, target 274. Next one is Elicon Engineering. Last trader price 782.60, stop loss 725, target 894. DB Corp. Last trader price 229, stop loss 210, target 266. Coal India reported a significant increase in 13.4% production in July 2023. PVR Inox reported a net loss of 81.6 crores. Siama SGS reported a 65% jump in net profit at 28.3 crores. Tribhuvan TBEZ reported 5-fold increase in net profit in the first quarter at 11.37 crores. This jewelry company is showing a good sign of profits. Motilal Oswal has recommended the following shares. Motherson Sumi Wiring, last trader price 59.50, target 70 rupees. Exide, last trader price 263, target 290. Coromandel International, last trader price 1043, targets 1185. JK Lakshmi Cement, last trader price 623, target 820. Macrotech Developers, last trader price 763, target 850. SBI Card, last trader price 881, target 970. Home First, last trader price 839, target 1010. Indian Oil Corporation, last trader price 93, target 110. Piramal Enterprises Limited, last trader price 1002, target 1260. Star Health Insurance, last trader price 640, target 730. M&M Finance, last trader price 296, target 370. Marico, last trader price 557, target 690. IDFC First Bank, last trader price 88, target 100. DCB Bank, neutral, last trader price 123, target 130. Indus Tower, neutral, last trader price 173.55, target 170. Some companies which will be announcing quarterly results today are Aditya Birla Capital, Adore Welding, Ambuja Cements, Amritanjan Healthcare, AE Engineering, Adani Wilmar Limited, Carborundum Universal, Cochin Minerals, Fasod Solutions Limited, Engineers India, Gateway Distriparks, Godrej Properties, Goodyear India, GPT Infra, Gujarat Gas, Hindustan Petroleum, Indigo, Indian Overseas Bank, Leica Lab, Mankind Pharma, Metro Plus, Nelcast, Narayana Kirdalia, Pradeep, Quest Corporation, Precall, Sapphire, Star Health, Sterling Tools, Titan, Vaibhav Global, VAP Industries, PSSL, etc. Stocks under F&O ban for today is India Bulls Housing Finance, Piramal Enterprises Limited, and Hindustan Copper. Some companies which will be ex-dividend from today are Adore Welding 17.50 rupees, Bajaj Consumer 5 rupees, BDH Industries 4 rupees, Centum Electronics 4 rupees, Crisil 8 rupees, Data Patterns 4.50 rupees, EAH Hotels 1.10, Hawkins Cooker 100 rupees, L&T 24 rupees and special dividend of 6 rupees, LMW 10 rupees, Menon Pistons 1 rupee, Shagyadri Industries 1 rupee 50 paisa, Share India Securities 4 rupee 50 paisa final dividend and interim dividend 2 rupees, Styrenix Performance Materials 24 rupees, TD Power Systems 50 paisa, Nintec Systems Limited bonus issue 4:5, X date is 3rd August 2023. ஆர்த்தி ட்ரக்ஸ் பைபேக் எக்ஸ்டேட் இஸ் 4th August 2023. அனுஜ் குப்தா ஸ்டாக்ஸ் ஃபார் டுடே ஆர் என்டிபிசி ஸ்டாப் லாஸ் 214, டார்ஜெட் 240. ஆக்சிஸ் பேங்க் ஸ்டாப் லாஸ் 934, டார்ஜெட் 1010. கணேஷ் டோங்கரேஸ் இன்ட்ராடே ஸ்டாக்ஸ் ஃபார் டுடே ஆர் HDFC Life பை 642, ஸ்டாப் லாஸ் 630, டார்ஜெட் 660. Reliance Industries Limited buy at 2518, stop loss 2490, target 2570. Smith Bagadia's intraday stocks for today are Escorts buy at 2563, stop loss 2510, target 2635. HCL Technology buy at 1138.50, stop loss 1110, target 1175. Cholamandalam Investors reported a net profit of 28% at ₹726 crores. Vaishali Parikh Prabhudas Lilladhar recommends the following stocks for today. They are Rights buy at 465, stop loss 459, target 484. Mahindra and Mahindra buy at 1493, stop loss 1475, target 1540. Asian Motors buy at 3415. Stop loss 3360, target 3530. Ambuja Cements to buy majority stake in Sanghi Indices. Sanghi Indices is now quoting at 95.65. Yesterday, it touched the upper circuits. Adani Total Gas reported 9% increase in consolidated net profit at 150 crores. RBI has imposed late submission fee of 2000 crores on ONGC Videsh Limited, Indian Oil Corporation, Gas Authority of India Limited, and Oil India. These all are the information available with me now for sharing. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you find this useful, please like the video, share it with your friends and relatives, and subscribe the video, please.